and welcome to African Home Building News and Analysis, brought to you by PE Live and sponsored by Adum City Estate, Goodkey Properties, and NALA. My name is Nanaya Ochirubia. Coming up in the headlines, Director of Ghana Property Awards has urged architects to come up with integrated solutions that protect the environment. President of GRIDA reiterates the need for sustainable architecture in Ghana's housing industry. And in international news, the residential real estate market in the US has screeched to a halt. Now the news in details. Architects urged to come up with integrated solutions, Director of Ghana Property Awards. The Director of Ghana Property Awards, Ms. Irene Ajinkwa, has challenged architects in the country not only to craft designs that excel in form and function, but also come up with integrated solutions that take into account environmental factors.
We therefore challenge our architects to not only craft designs that excel in form and function, but also come up with integrated solutions that take into account environmental factors.
Speaking at this year's Ghana Property Awards and Dinners Night at the Accra International Conference Center, Ms. Ajinkwa also urged property developers to be intentional in this regard. Touching on the theme for the 14th edition of the awards, Sustainable Architecture in Ghana's Housing Mix, she highlighted the importance of sustainable architecture. The director of the Ghana Property Awards said there was honest professionals in the industry who, in spite of Ghana's challenges, have demonstrated perseverance, resilience, and continue to offer excellent services by enabling transactions in the industry. She paid glowing tribute to the developers who are pushing forward, the brokers who are still brokering transactions, the architects who are still designing, and to the service providers who are crafting solutions.
We also implore our developers who build the houses to be intentional in this regard. For tonight, let's honor those whom, in spite of all our current enormous challenges, have shown perseverance, resilience, ingenuity, and excellence to provide services and enable transactions in the housing industry.
She added that Ghana was grateful to all professionals in the built environment for their dynamism and great spirit. She expressed enormous appreciation to all partners, sponsors, and the Ministry of Works and Housing for the support and counsel.
To all our partners, sponsors, and supporters, we can't thank you enough. To the Ministry of Works and Housing, we truly appreciate you for always standing by us and giving us your enormous support and counsel. God bless each and every one of you for your participation and presence tonight. Aiko.
Still staying on architecture, sustainable architecture is the future. GRIDA President. President of the Ghana Real Estate Developers Association, Mr. Patrick Ebo Bonfo, has said that the subject of sustainability is a topical matter globally and one that requires serious attention. He said at the just ended 2022 Climate Summit, the single underlying theme that ran through the things discussed was the issue of sustainability. It is widely researched among scientists that if care is not taken, the earth resources will be depleted.
The single underlying theme that ran through all the various issues discussed was the issue of sustainability. It is widely accepted among scientists, researchers, and society at large that if care is not taken, the Earth's resources will be depleted to the point that the Earth can no longer replenish itself and support life here on Earth.
Speaking at the 14th Ghana Property Awards organized by the Property Express Group in Accra, Mr. Bonfu was of the view that sustainable architecture was the future of the built environment, adding that the architecture was a powerful tool that drives imagination of the built environment as a change agent. It could be harnessed to address the issue of sustainability, socially and economically.
Is sustainable architecture the future? I believe so, certainly. Architecture is a powerful tool that almost single-handedly drives dreams and imaginations in the built environment. And it has been doing so since the beginning of human civilization. As a change agent, architecture can help shape and influence the social psyche in all its forms. The architectural sector directly or indirectly addresses the issue of sustainability socially, economically, and environmentally.
The president of GREDA said the construction sector was a major consumer of non-renewable natural resources and can be guided through sustainable architecture to significantly reduce the negative impact on our environment. Mr. Bonfu highlighted some benefits of sustainable architecture, such as energy-efficient lighting systems, cooling and ventilation systems, rain gutter harvesting, and some sustainable building materials such as wood, ram earth, and bamboo, amongst others. He was hopeful that sustainable architecture could bring about change as it addresses the use of natural resources to minimize the negative effects on our environment.
There are 6 ways architecture can help achieve the sustainability agenda, and they are: 1, the use of low environmental impact building materials; 2, the use of cool roofs, including the use of thatch; renewable energy, rainwater harvesting, modular construction practices; and last but not the least, use of smart appliances.
Tobiga Gabusi VII, the paramount chief of B traditional area, Hohoi, says the area needs urgent reforms in its land administration system to match the new Land Act 2020, which is the Act 1036. According to him, an efficient local land administration will no doubt bring order and discipline into our physical development space and trigger a departure from the chaotic manner in which we put up houses, buildings, and many other physical structures in the country. Tobiga Gabusu, at his installment and coronation, said the Bi traditional area with Hohoi as its capital had first assumed a cosmopolitan status, which called for reforms in terms of traditional land administration. We'll go for a short break. Please stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back from the break. Now, in international news, the residential real estate market in the US has squeaked to a halt. The residential real estate market in the US has squeaked to a halt, and some economists believe home prices are about to drop significantly. Existing home sales have fallen for 9 straight months. The supply of single-family homes is growing, and with mortgage rates near 7%, experts say a large-scale housing slowdown is becoming increasingly likely. Adding that existing home prices will keep falling, ultimately dropping by 20% from the existing June peak of around $414,000. Goldman Sachs analyst has recently cut their outlook for home prices from roughly flat next year to down 4%, noting that unsustainable levels of housing affordability to continue weighing on housing demand. Until recently, economists had poo-pooed the prospect of a nationwide price slump, suggesting that persistently low inventories of houses to buy would put something of a flaw on that the market. Even if demand fell because of surging mortgage rates, they risen, there would still be enough buyers for the relatively small number of houses for sale, meaning prices likely wouldn't drop much. That's all for news this evening. Thank you for staying with us, and a very big thank you to Good Key Properties, Adum City Estate, and NALA. For more news, please visit our website, www.propertyexpress.org. You can also follow us on social media. We're on Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, and Facebook at Property Express. My name is Nanaya Otribia, and this has been PA Live. Have a good evening.